Hi dear students and friends, you are warm welcome on this GeoEntire YouTube channel that is all about the earth. So today we will discuss an important topic in geology, that is the Buster Craton. When we look the geological map of India, it consists of different types of rocks, different types of tectonic zones, different types of mobile belts, and there are also different types of craton. So basically, when we look the map of India, so it consists of five cratons. First one is the Singhbhum Craton, second one is the Arvali Craton, third one is the Bundelkhand Craton, then fourth one is the Dharwar Craton, and last craton, that is the Buster Craton. In this video, we are going to discuss the geographical location of this Buster Craton. What are the different types of rocks which are present in the Buster Craton, and what are the lithotectonic units which are present in the Buster Craton? These aspects I am going to discuss in more detail, particularly in this lesson. So craton means tectonically stable region. It attain and maintain long term stability. It is exact opposite to the mobile belts. Mobile belts are not stable. They continuously in the tectonic movement. So mobile belts are different. Indian continent, it is also consist of mobile belts. So compared to these mobile belts, these craton are older one. They attain and maintain tectonic stability. So this is nothing but the craton. So now we will discuss, so what is Buster Craton? So you know that Buster Craton, it covers an area near about 130,000 square kilometer area of the India. So it is bounded. You see in this figure, this Buster Craton is bounded to the, you see in the southern direction of this Buster Craton, there is the Godavari Graben. So this Buster Craton is bounded to Godavari Graben towards southern side. Towards northeast, you see in this northeast direction, this Buster Craton is bounded to the Mahanadi Graben. So this is the Mahanadi Graben. Then towards the north of this Buster Craton, there is a Satpura Mobile Belt. Therefore, this craton is bounded to the Satpura Mobile Belts. Then the eastern side, there is a Eastern Ghat Mobile Belts, and towards the western side, that is the Deccan Basalt, that is called as particularly Maharashtra state. This Maharashtra state, particularly the Deccan Trap. So this is the geographical location of this Buster Craton. Now in earlier literature, it is also called as Bhandara Craton, or it is also called as Central Indian Craton. So this is nothing but the Buster Craton. Now what are the different main components which are shown in the Buster Craton? So Buster Craton consists of basically six lithotectonic units. So first one is the gneissic complex with granites of different ages. When we look the granites in this Buster Craton having different ages, so therefore this is one of the main component in the Buster Craton. Then second component, that is the granulite belts. Then third component which is found in the Buster Craton, that is the Kothri Dongargarh Orogen. Then fourth, that is the isolated fold belts of the Bengpal, Sakuli and Sonkhan. So these are the three areas where these isolated folded beds found. Fifth one is the mafic dike swamps. So there are mafic dikes found in the different localities in the particularly in the Buster Craton and having different composition. Then last component, that is the Proterozoic Purana basins. These are the six basic components which are found in the Buster Craton. Now we will see one by one. So you see Buster Craton having different lithotectonic units. So first we will discuss, that is the gneissic complex with granites of different ages. you see toward my upper side, there is a lithotectonic unit map. So this map is consist of gneissic complex with granite of different ages. Particularly, this first unit consists of TTG. TTG means tonalite trongemite granodiorite. So that is called as TTG, and it is exposed towards south and western part of the Buster Craton. The gneisses having, so whatever the gneisses present in the Buster Craton having ages, that is the 2500 to 2600 million years. So this is the age of this TTG gneisses. It is very significant because the major crustal accretion event has been happening, events are stored in the these TTG granites or gneissic complex. Then the Merkampara gneiss in south of Buster Craton having age 3510 million years, and there is again Kapsi gneiss is there. It is present in the central Buster Craton and having age, that is the 3510 million years. So this is nothing but the Merkampara gneiss and Kapsi gneiss. TTG, that is the tonalite trongemite granodiorite. So this TTG gneiss is enclosed with BIF, that is the banded iron formations and mafic ultramafic rocks, belongs to the Sukma group, that is the Buster and Amgao group of Bhandara region. So this BIF consists of the iron deposits. This BIF is very very important for the iron deposit in this particular craton. Large bodies of granites are intruded in the gneisses and supracrustals. The whatever the granites are there, they are intruded into the gneisses. So therefore the granites are younger than the gneiss. Then you see in that particular area, there is a Malanjkhand area. This Malanjkhand granite is contemporaneous with the Dongargarh granites and which shows porphyry type of copper deposits. So this Buster Craton having lot of economic importance, which shows some copper deposits also. So therefore this Buster Craton is very very important. Then it is again shows different types of granite, that is the Kankar granites, and which forms the basement of the Purana basins. Again there is a Jiram granite, which is very very important for the tin deposit, lepidolite, mica and pegmatitic mineralization. So therefore this Jiram granite also very very important. There are again one more granite is there, that is the Sukuma granite, and which underlies Sabri Purana basins. So this is nothing but the gneissic complex with granites of different ages and having different types of economic importance. Then second main component or lithotectonic units which is present in the Buster Craton, that is the granulite belts. You see there are two prominent belts which are present in the Buster Craton. These two belts are Bholapatnam granulite belt and second is the Kondgaon granulite belts. So Bholapatnam granulite, it is a northern side of the Godavari graben. You see here there is a Godavari basin is there, Godavari graben is there, and at the northern sides of the Godavari graben, this Bholapatnam granulite is there, and it also conceals contact between Dharwar craton and Bundelkhand craton. So therefore this Bholapatnam granulite, which is very very important. Then there is a second belt, that is the Kondgaon granulite belts. So this Kondgaon granulite belts, it emerges from northern margin of Indravati, that is the Purana basin in the cratonic interior. There is again one more third belt there, that is called as Balaghat Bhandara granulite belts, and it forms the CITZ, that is the Central Indian Tectonic Zone at the cratonic boundary, but this is the described under the Satpura mobile belts. So therefore this is the out of this particularly Buster Craton. So therefore basically there are two types of granulite belts which are present in the Buster Craton. Then third lithotectonic units which is present in the Bastar Craton, that is the Kothri Dongargrah Orogen. So this Kothri Dongargrah Orogen, it consists of, it is a long north-south trending belts. It consists of several cycles of sedimentation and volcanism. And when we go towards the northern side of this particular belt, the younger rocks toward the northern side of this particularly these belts. This is described as intracratonic orogen because it does not extend beyond the Bastar Craton. So therefore it is called as intracratonic orogen. It consists of several volcano sedimentary cycles and are ascending order, such as, so there are different types of volcano sedimentary cycles. So the first one, that is the basic volcanic BIF, that is the banded iron formations, associations of Bailadila groups. So this basic volcanic BIF is very, very important for the iron deposit. When we go into the Bailadila hills, that is very, very famous for the iron deposit. Then second volcano sedimentary cycle, which is found in this particularly Bastar Craton, that is the mafic felsic volcanic and pyroclastic of Nandgaon group. Then third one is the mafic volcanics of alternating with clastic. So this is again belongs to the Nandgaon group. Then fourth cycle, volcano sedimentary cycle, that is the Gravaki Pilite association with minor carbonates and it having some manganese deposits and which belongs to the volcanic, that is the volcanic having composition, that is the felsic composition, silica content or silica composition is very high. So therefore this is felsic in nature and it belongs to the Chilpi group. So this is nothing but the Bastar Craton Kothri Dongargrah Orogen. Then fourth unit, tectonic unit, which is related to this Bastar Craton, this is isolated fold belts. So these fold belts are occupied, or it consists of gneiss rock, and these isolated folds belts are generally three belts are there. So first one is the Sakoli belt, second one is the Sonakam belt, and third one is the Bengpal belt. So now we will see what is Sakoli belts. So this Sakoli belt is bounded to the shear zones on the three sides, and it consists of pilites with felsic volcanics and pyroclastic, and there is a minor mafic, ultramafic rocks are there, and which are very, very important for the banded iron formation, tourmaline, copper, zinc, and there is also some gold deposit found in this particular Sakoli belts, that is the folded belt which is present in the Bastar Craton. Then Sonakam belt, this belt is also called as greenstone belts. It consists of pillowed basic volcanics and tuffs, and this Sonakam belt is overlain by thick conglomerate. That is a conglomerate is the sedimentary rock, and this belt is overlain by a thick conglomerate rock. Then third belt, that is a fold belt, that is the Bengpal belts. So this belt having trend, that is the west northwest to east southeast direction, and it extend from Bailadila hills to the EZMB, that is the Eastern Ghat Mobile belts, and it consists of amygdalo basalt, andalusite, phyllite, arenite associations. So this is nothing but the isolated folded beds. Then fifth unit, which is found in the Bastar Craton, that is the mafic dike swarms. So these are the prominent, these dikes are the prominent near Bijapur, Gidam and Kondgam and Keshkal area. These dikes are of amphibolites, epidorites and dolerites of variable composition, and it having a trend, that is a northwest direction. So this is nothing but the mafic dikes which are present in the particularly in this Bastar Craton. Then last, that is the sixth lithotectonic unit, that is the Proterozoic Purana basins. This Proterozoic Purana basins belongs to, or it found at the Abujamar, Chhattisgarh, Khariyar, Ammapani, Indravati, Sabri and Pranahita Godavari basins. These are the localities where these Proterozoic Purana basins are found. And generally these Proterozoic Purana basins having flat bedded sequence of quartzite, carbonate, pyrite and resting on Precambrian basement of gneiss and granites. So these are the six major lithotectonic units which are present in the Buster Craton. So dear students, we have seen that the geographical location of this Buster Craton, what are the different types of lithotectonic units which are present in the Buster Craton. So I hope you understand the Buster Craton regarding the introductory part of this Buster Craton. But in next video, we will take the remaining part of this Buster Craton, that is the stratigraphy of Buster Craton. So this part we will see in the next video. So we will meet in the next video. So if you like my video, then share and subscribe my YouTube channel, that is GeoEntire. Thank you.